Alright, good evening guys, Rich Hondra here, Shift Transformation. So today, got another free workout for you. Gonna do something a little bit different. I'm gonna actually go through the entire workout with you here. So this is something that you can just follow along with in real time. Alright, and all you need is some space, one dumbbell. Try to make it pretty challenging, but for the most of this, it's gonna be body weight stuff. And that's about it. You're not really gonna need a stopwatch because I'll be doing the timing for us. But let's get into it. We got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We got 6 Tabatas. Again, that's 24 minutes of work, 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. All right, let's get into it. So the first Tabata, what we're gonna do is, we're gonna do a floor tricep press, which I'll show you, and we're gonna do an isometric hold in that position. So we'll alternate for each of those things. So in Tabata, we have 8 rounds, obviously. So we're going to do the first 20 seconds doing the actual exercise. The second 20 seconds, we'll do an isometric hold. We'll alternate like that for 8 rounds, totaling 4 minutes of work. We'll take a short break in between the Tabatas, but we want to try to keep it going, get the conditioning effect up, keep it super intense, build the muscle, burn the fat. All right, so let's do this first one. So if you have a box or just a dumbbell or whatever, just something to put your feet up on for this particular exercise. All right, and what you're gonna do, you're gonna put your feet on there and you're gonna scoot your butt in just a little bit. And we're just gonna be doing a tricep dip just like this. All right, so let's get it going. We're gonna start the clock. We're gonna do 20 seconds of that and then we'll go into a isometric hold in that position for 20 seconds. All right, ready, let's do it. First 20 seconds, start repping. And if you ever have to rest during it, quickly rest and get back to repping as quick as you can. All right, 10 second rest. When we come back, we're gonna do an isometric hold for 20 seconds. In 3, 2, and 1, scooch that butt in and make sure there's tension on the triceps. You're not in a locked out position, just somewhere where there's tension. Try to lean back slightly to get that tension even better. All right, 10 second break. After the 10 second break, we'll go right back into repping. Let's do this back and forth for 4 minutes. 3, 2, and 1. Scooch in, lean back just a little. Good solid reps, get good contraction at the top. Okay, 10 second break. I don't know if I'm making through that next 20 seconds on that one, we'll see. All right, let's get into our isometric hold, 20 seconds. Just hold it. And you're gonna start to shake and you're gonna feel burning. You gotta put your butt down a second. Fine, get it back up. 3, 2, and 1. Take your break, shake those arms out. Halfway through this thing, guys. In 3, 2, 1, back to repping. Got to take a break there a second. We got 5 more seconds. Get as many reps as you can. Great. 10 second break. 3, 2, 1, isometric hold, lean back, bend those elbows just a little bit, hold it out as long as you can. Go. Big them out. Get right back to repping. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay. Do one more isometric hold. In 3, 2, 1. Hang in there as long as you can. This will end this first to bottom. We'll shake it out and get into the next one. Second, shake it out. We'll get into the next Tabata in just a second. All right, guys, so here we go. Let's get into Tabata number 2, which is we're gonna do some chest and a little bit of hamstring work, actually, in an isometric fashion. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna be in a reverse bridge position, which I'm gonna show you here in a second, and we're gonna be repping with one arm with a dumbbell for the chest. In this Tabata, for the 8 rounds, we'll alternate between arms each round, 20 seconds on the right arm, 20 seconds on the left arm, while we're in this reverse bridge position, okay? So, let's get right into that. I'm gonna try to use a dumbbell that's pretty darn challenging here, so we'll see. I might have to go down, I don't know. Anyway, so, the first part of this is, guys, you wanna get yourself in a reverse bridge position. I don't want you standing like this, there's no tension. Get the legs straight out, just like that. And you can have a little bit wider base with your feet. So spread your feet out a little bit so you have a good wide base. You want to feel tension in your hamstrings and your glutes, and you're kind of resting right on your upper back, all right? Your butt's not on the ground. We're keeping good tension, isometric work here. That's what we're looking to do. Get this clock in the right spot here. Let's see what I'm doing. All right, and then while you're in that position, get your dumbbell. Bring your tricep down to the ground, up, and we're just doing a chest press, just like that. So go relatively heavy because we're gonna be switching arms each round. So your arm is gonna get to rest a bit. All right, so let's get into it. All right, let's go, 20 seconds. I like to keep my hand on my chest so I can feel that contraction, but you could have your arm out to your side for balance, whatever you want to do. Grab my stopwatch here, sorry guys. Alright, 10 second break. Get that dumbbell to the other side, ready to go. In 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Get back to repping. Break. Very good. 10 second break. Get that dumbbell to the side. If you have 2 dumbbells, just keep one on each side. But as I mentioned at the top of this, we just need 1. Let's go back on this side and start repping. Do this with a kettlebell too. Break, 10 second break. Usually I use a Tabata timer for this, guys, but I'm using my phone for this video, so I can't use it. So if you have a Tabata timer, just use that instead of holding a stopwatch like me. Reps, guys. All right, break. Halfway through this thing. Don't rush the reps. Full range of motion. In 3, 2, 1. Back to repping. Switch it up. Keep it going, guys. 5, four, three, two, one. Five more seconds, keep it going. All right, great. All right, that's 8 minutes of work, that's two Tabatas. Let's keep it going. Tabata number three, coming up. All right, here we go, guys. Tabata number three, your next 4 minutes is gonna be spent doing crouching, posted push-ups, ear to ground. All right, so the hand that's posted will switch each round that we do. Again, 8 rounds, nothing different. 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. You're just gonna switch the arm that is posted. So take that one dumbbell that you have, all right? And you're gonna get one hand on the dumbbell, one hand on the ground, relatively wide, okay? So instead of doing a normal push-up with your leg straight out, come in, crouch in, and bring your ear to the ground, just like that. All right, this is gonna put obviously some emphasis on the chest, but mostly front delt, all upper area here. All right, let's get into it. 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. Ready, go. Take your time with this, do good form, guys. A little bit strenuous. First 20 seconds, move that dumbbell over, take 10 seconds off, all right? Try to keep most of the weight on that ground floor, the ground hand. Ready? Go. And get that ear to the ground, guys. Don't cheat. Great. Now, if you're just beginning, guys, you can't do that, do them on the knees, just like that, all right? Let's get into round number three. It's much more difficult, all right? That's that one. Again, just like anything else, guys, you have to rest a second, get back to repping, you gotta drop down to knee level, no problem. Ready? Let's go. Number four. Three, two, and one. down for a second here. 5 more seconds, get a few more reps. All right, 10 second break. Got 1 round left on each arm. Hope you guys are doing good. Drop down to those knees if needed. Let's go. Failing at 3 reps, we're getting some mass building now. 5 more seconds. That's that. Got 1 rep left on that other arm. This is great, guys. We're working the failure over and over again. That's how you're going to build muscle with this. Super intense. Let's knock it out. Last one. Woo, 10 seconds. That's it, guys. All right. That was the most challenging one so far. All right, that's Tabata number 3. And we got 3 to go. All right, so 12 minutes in. Get ready for Tabata number 4. All right, here we go, guys. Tabata number 4. So now let's shift the focus to our back. All right, no dumbbell needed for this. We're just going to be on our using body weight on our back. And again, we'll alternate for the 8 rounds back and forth between 2 different exercises. First one is you're going to lay on your back. You're going to use your elbows to bring yourself up. And when you do that, do not try to use your abs for this. Let your abs relax as much as possible and lift yourself and squeeze your upper back and lats together as you do that. We're going to rep out like that. And then for the second part, we'll do an isometric hold. Do get yourself up on your elbows, just like that, and just lift your butt off the ground just a little bit, and you'll hold for 20 seconds. That's a doozy. All right, guys, ready for this Tabata number 4. All right, ready? Hold on a second, let me get this. Let's go. 20 seconds of repping. Good contraction. Use just those elbows to pick yourself up. All right, 10 second break. Now get yourself ready for this. Start with the tension on the elbows already. Don't try to put yourself up and then get up. Ready, set. So get the elbows up, just like this. Get your butt off the ground. That butt up. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. All right, that's a tough one. You can't do it. Just rest during that period. Ready? Let's go back up to the elbows, pushing us up. Ready? Go. I don't care how many reps you get, guys. Make each one of them count. More seconds. All right, break. 10 second break. We go back into our isometric hold in 5 seconds. Get yourself ready. You're leaning on your elbows. Right up. You may want to have a towel or a yoga mat or do this on the carpet in the living room or something because you're going to mess up your elbows. So I got some padding under mine, so it's not bad, but don't do it on tile or on a rug. All right, down. All right, halfway through this joker. In 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, go. Squeeze that back. Come down, lift the elbows off the ground just a little bit, put them back, and go. So there's no momentum. Five seconds. second. We'll go back into our hold. Ready, set, go. Make sure when you're doing this hold that you're breathing. Do not hold your breath. You'll feel lightheaded. You may pass out. So anytime you do an isometric static holding, you gotta make sure you're breathing. All right, down. One more of each, guys, and be through this Tabata. Couple little 4 minutes here. All right, 3, 2, 1, back to repping. And be explosive, guys. Explode up, slow down. Explode up, slow down. Again, keep your breathing. All right, break, shake it out. One more, we'll be adding this Tabata right here. In 3, 2, 1. Hold it for 20 seconds. Make sure that butt stays up. 10 more seconds. Don't quit. You gotta put your butt down a second, get it right back up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, that is Tabata number 4. We got 2 to go. Tabata number 5 coming up in just a second. All right, guys, Tabata number 5. So now we're gonna start getting to a little more conditioning, getting the lower body more involved. So we did have some hamstring activation with those reverse bridge style things we're doing, but now we're gonna get into some quad and lower body. And this is Tabata number 5. Tabata number 6 is all conditioning. But right now, we're gonna do some legs, and we do a kickstand squat here. So for the 8 rounds, we'll alternate back and forth between left and right leg. Okay, a kickstand squat, guys. What I want you to do, stand, feet shoulder width apart. Take one step out, one step back, all right? Now, I don't want you all your weight on this back foot. We're gonna be working the right leg. If all the weight is back, you're not going to be getting anything on that leg. So I want everything up front, just a toe on the ground for support, okay? And we're just going to do a squat like this. 20 seconds here, 20 seconds there, back and forth for 4 minutes. All right? So let's get into it. Ready, set. Get yourself set before I start this clock. Shoulder width, step out, step back. Get the weight up just on your toe. Let's do it. Touch your fingers to the ground. Good form, guys. We're not rushing again. We want good, solid form. Get that thigh parallel with the ground. Try to keep your chest and head up as much as possible. All right, good. 10-second break. Work the other leg, same way. Step it out. Step it back. Get all the weight up in front. Ready, set, and go. Second break. All right, get yourself ready. Step out, step back. All the weight centered on that leg. Go. Front leg. 5 more seconds. All the way down. Good, break. Shake it out. 3, 2, and 1, go. 20 seconds. Left leg or the opposite leg that you were doing. See him stopping at top, stopping at bottom, not using a lot of momentum. Break. One on each leg left. Use that other leg. Out, back, lean forward, go. Good job, guys. That is 20 minutes of work. Let's take a short break. Get into the bottom number 6, our final one. Get your mind right for it, all conditioning coming at you in just a second. All right, to bottom number 6 coming at you right now, the final one, our final 4 minutes. We got 4 different moves that we'll run through 2 times to, you know, make the 8 rounds. All right, so now that we did some muscle building, now let's get shredded. And this is gonna accomplish that. So we're gonna do a renegade row plyo push-up for the first 20 seconds. We're gonna do a split squat for the next 20 seconds. We're gonna do a broad jump for 20 seconds, and then we're gonna do donkey kicks for 20 seconds, okay? So follow me on the moves, guys. So the first one is going to be a renegade row without weights plyo push-up, okay? So let me get this thing on the ground there. So quickly, let me show you what that is. You'd be in a plank position here, just like this. It's gonna be renegade row, plyo. Renegade row, plyo push-up. All right, that's that. A split squat jump. That'd be the second move. The broad jumps. Try to jump as far as you can. Twist around. That'd be your broad jump. Donkey kicks, obviously. Keep yourself in control. All right, I'm already breathing heavy, just demonstrating, but let's give it our all on this last one, guys. We're 4 minutes away. All right, let's go. Renegade row, plyo push-up. If you gotta do the push-up on your knees at this point, fine. Ready? Let's go. Donkey kicks coming up. Ready. go. Guys, renegade plyos, ready, go. Don't quit, guys, we're halfway done. Mess that one up. All right, 10 second break. Split squat jumps, come on, guys, don't quit. Breathing heavy, but I'm not quitting. Ready? Go. Feel the burn, go right through it. 3, 2, 1. Broad jumps, guys. Get down low. Slow it up. Ready? Go. Twist around. Let me know how you like it. And that's it, Rich Hollinger, Shift Transformations.